Howdy, this is Review 64 with another review for you. Today we are doing my first animated Transformer review, and we're going to start it out with Voyager Bulkhead. Well, personally, I like the figure. Both his car mode and his robot mode are really great. Despite him being small, especially for a Voyager class figure, he still is jam-packed with detail and is pretty show accurate. Okay, here we have the packaging, and personally, I love the packaging. It's really big for a Voyager figure. Anyway, you have nice box art of Bulkhead on the side with the Transformers logo. I like the whole design of the box is in the Transformers logo way, in that there are sharp angles and three-dimensional effects. Within just having, you know, jam-packed with information, you got other figures on the wave on the bottom. On the top, more box art of Bulkhead. On the side, you got just some little pop-ups and more box art. And on the other side, more Voyager class figures of this line. Really, really, really great packaging. I love it. It's really big and jam-packed with information. When you flip it over, you'll see a big picture of the figure in both this robot mode and SWAT vehicle mode, along with a detailed description of the actions of the character based on show information. He also has another Bulkhead box right there. It gives just descriptions on his gimmicks and whatnot. Anyway, I love the packaging. It's really, really great. There's great colors and overall design is awesome. Really jam-packed with information and definitely a box to be keeping. Okay, now for the detail of his SWAT vehicle mode. Now, the show takes place 50 years in the future, so he is meant to be futuristic. And he's really nice, really show accurate, in that they have the headlights and everything all pretty nice. You got the stars on each side. Overall, I mean, he is green, and you got gold rims. Wheels roll really nicely. Really, really great SWAT vehicle mode. He is a little bit small, despite how big you think he is, like I thought he was. Here's a comparison to the Concept Camaro Transformers movie line figure. You know, he's like three times as big and just the same height. So just picture that. So he's really not that long if you think about it, especially for such a big character and Voyager glass figure. So, he's probably deluxe size in my book, you know. I'd put him as deluxe, so he's $10 more, since he is Voyager. One thing I don't like is that they don't have translucent yellow plastic for the headlights. They did that for some of their figures, but not all of them, so it's understandable. I just think that if they were doing a Voyager class figure, they would have put a little bit more into it. Also, with the light bars up here, would have preferred translucent red plastic. My only real complaint is that he's really small for a Voyager class figure, and you're kind of not getting what you paid for within plastic, you know. And the top is that it's not completely covered, it has this caved in effect because of the arms. I don't like that. Honestly, I don't really mind it, just it is kind of weird. But overall, great detail. I love the whole look of it, even though it is small, and he's just a nice SWAT vehicle mode. I give it a 9 out of 10 just because he is small and this little opening. Okay, here we have the robot mode of the figure. The robot mode is really great. I love the whole look of this character, and the figure really does bring justice to him, in that he is pretty show accurate, getting the same basic design elements to him without discluding some minor stuff. But overall, you still get the same figure character you see in the show. On the back, I don't like, it's kind of a minus for me, is that you kind of just get this inside-out vehicle mode kind of thing in the back. Don't really like that. But overall, he has this really, really nice look to him. He's actually really, really cool. The main colors on here are green, black in the front. He has actually just painted on yellow, yellow headlights. Five or stars on either arm and I believe on the shoulders. Also, he has a really small head, just to point that out. Like, you would think it would be bigger, but it's actually really, really small due to this automorph he comes with. The opposite colors are this really, really light bronze, which I'm not sure if it's featured in the show, but, you know, it works nicely for this figure. His Autobot symbol is up here. Really nice. It's really well defined on here. Silver among the green. It works really nicely for this figure. Overall, the detail of this figure, I would give a 9 out of 10, being the only problem with the inside-out stuff on the back. Overall, everything else is really, really great on him, and I like him a lot. Okay, now we have the articulation of this figure and his robot mode. He does have a lot of articulation, and not really even a lot. It's more of just places that he needs it. They haven't spared a lot of articulation on these figures, in that they're really all just articulation where they need to be. And that he has a lockable ball joint within the upper shoulder, a swivel tricep, a normal joint within the elbow, and surprisingly, it is a lot of articulation for his arms, including the three-pronged hands, really nice. He does have head articulation, but like the other figures of this line, or at least most of them, it spins on an angle, so you're really not getting that great. I don't think it really hurts the figure for me, because I don't see Bulkhead getting in any cooler positions with his head moved. And the legs, although they are really, really small, just see how small they are, they actually do have a lot of articulation that they can move up and down with lockable joints to the side, a lockable normal joint within the knee along with a swivel knee, and that's all he really has. But honestly, I like it a lot. Great articulation. I forgot to go into this, but he does have gimmicks, if you will. One is this elbow thing, which isn't really that great. You just push it up and it moves up. Not the best thing in the world, but I guess it's nice to have for a Voyager class figure. But the one thing I like is this one, where it actually has a hidden trigger, if you will, and you just push it back and shazam, his wrecking ball comes out. Really, really nice. I like this. It's pretty nice articulation just where needed, and it works really great for this figure. Well, my final thoughts on the line is that it's really great line. They have simple transformations, really, really nice detail in that for simple, you know, cars and bots that they are. They are really, really nice. They bring back some of the great characters with classic G1 paints and whatnot. Just really, really great figures. I recommend picking them up. You get used to these easy transformations that are kind of confusing to comprehend when you first get them, but they come together nicely after a little bit more time with them. Overall, I definitely recommend this line. It's really, really great. Great show to go along with it, so you can continue playing, you know, with your figures all year because of the show going on. I cannot recommend them enough. The packaging's great. Articulation, just where the spots are needed. Overall detail, great. I just love the whole look of this figure and figures of this line. Definitely one of the stronger figures, although you'll notice when you get these figures that they are small, and especially this Voyager class figure, which is actually really, really small. But overall, really, really nice detail, great articulation, and a really awesome line. I definitely recommend picking them up, but don't get them in bulk. Just buy one at a time, see if you like them, and, you know, do that. Anyway, there are some quality control issues I just want to say on some of the figures where they sometimes break. I know my Bumblebee already broke after one day, so watch out for that. Anyway, I definitely recommend this line. It's a great line, great TV show. Go out and watch it. And Bulkhead is an awesome figure, although he is rather small. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed my review. Expect more coming up. Anyway, definitely recommend this line. Great, great figures. Anyway, this is Review 64, signing out.